Well, the plastic manufacturers do not make plastics that are economically recyclable, because if they would do so, they would make it very easy for the competition, for the recyclers, to compete with them on the market. And it is in fact very unattractive for them to make the perfect polymer, the polymer that you could recycle endlessly. Because if they would do that, they would make their own production processes obsolete. And the big reason behind that is that they did not integrate recycling into their own process, like all the other material manufacturers. It is clear that consumers want plastics that are recyclable. They want products where all the materials that are in the products are circular, are being renewed into high-value new materials. And the producers of those consumer products, they know that. And what you see as a beginning trend at this moment is that people that produce food, packaged food, microelectronics, cars, everybody is now looking at the possibility of recycling their own plastics. So all the big companies are now thinking, okay, if plastics are so difficult to recycle, I'm going to do it myself. And they are looking at groups like ours to see if there are beautiful technologies that can do that. And once they take that initiative, the problem is solved, because they will refuse to buy polymers that are not well recyclable. And they will create a pressure on the polymer manufacturers to produce good plastics. We can already make polymers that are perfectly recyclable. That is not an issue. But to recycle them, we have now grown used to plastics as a very colorful material, for example. Plastics are produced in hundreds of different colors, very often the color of the brand. And that is something that we would like to keep. In principle, it's more difficult to recycle hundreds of different colors of plastics than a single color. But it is possible. And for that, we have to move to technologies in which electronics plays an important role, in which we have thousands of microscopic robots, which takes all these plastics flakes into different categories. So the yellow flakes into a yellow product, the red flakes into a red product. Actually, even what we would like to do is that if a brand produces a particular bottle of soap, and that bottle has a particular color blue, we would actually like to take from the waste plastics precisely those flakes and bring them back to the producer. We've been testing this concept at a German producer. And the strange thing, it turns out that if you make flakes really very pure, both clean and of the right type of polymer, then it turns out that you can immediately turn that into a bottle. So there's no intermediate chemistry needed or processes. So in principle, the product manufacturers, they can immediately take those flakes and make them into products again.